Hey collectors, here is a look at He-Man and the Masters of the Universe Duncan or Man-at-Arms cartoon collection version from Mattel, and I would like to thank Rare Fine Toys for this. Link in the description below. Check them out. For collectors who will not be opening this figure, be warned that the card is very thin and you may have difficulty in finding a pristine condition on the shelves of your local toy stores. At the back of the card, you can see a specific scene plus a specific weapon or accessory which comes with this figure, plus pictures of the other characters for this wave of cartoon collection. Out of the package, it comes with a free mini comic book, and Duncan or Man-at-Arm comes in a small plastic tray with two accessories at the back. Out of the plastic tray, the figure stands at 6 inches tall, and I would like to remind every one of you that you can straighten out the legs of this figure. Because for some weird reason, Mattel has some inclination of making muscular squatting men as their signature for their toy line. And this is what the details on the back of the figure looks like. It is what you can see in the Filmation cartoons for the Masters of the Universe. Once you find the center of balance for Duncan, this figure can hold simple action poses. But again, I don't recommend you leaving it without any support, because a little nudge and this figure will surely fall down on your display. Duncan comes with his mace and another accessory specific to one scene, which is indicated at the back of the card. He can hold them both on each of his hands, but unfortunately you will be stuck with those kind of hand poses because this figure only comes with the default hands. There are joints that you can twist and turn on his arms and wrist for you to be able to make the pose that you can see at the back of the card, with Duncan holding the stasis ray with both hands. Although Mattel is trying to emulate what we see in the cartoons because of the Filmation drawing, this effort of them to bring out a new body sculpt for the cartoon collection line is half-hearted. If you look at the figure, the upper half of the body is okay, but the lower part is somewhat small for me and is not proportioned. Still, at 2024, Mattel cannot let go of their fetish with muscular squatting men. They could have easily just did a normal human body proportion. Instead, most of their mindset are that Eternians are gym goers and everyone is buff. Also, the figure, if you look at it at the side, is like a dwarf from Moria. So I hope they would do another line of this with some kind of body proportion improvement. But for the time being, I guess we are going to be stuck with this kind of body buck until most of the characters are released in the cartoon collection line. Aside from the body not being proportioned for a normal human, Mattel should have included an extra head sculpt without the helmet and extra sets of hands for this figure. And for size comparison, here he is with Snake Eyes from G.I. Joe Classified and Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man boat figure from Hasbro, with Buzz Lightyear from Toy Story by Bandai Model Kit, and Voltes 5 from the Voltes 5 anime SMP line by Bandai Model Kit. with Asagi Yojimbo, and from the box set, Turtles in Disguise, Donatello, both figures from the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles cartoon series by NECA. And to wrap things up, here is Duncan with Skeletor and He-Man, both figures from Super 7. And with that, thank you all for watching. And see you all again next video.